Shalom, Christian Ethics 30. For those who missed this lecture, what we talked about was love and relationships. So we're going from interfaith relationship, interfaith friendship, going beyond this idea of being right and being instead being love and be able to see what we can learn from each other, and this idea of the universal Christ, Christ everywhere, always in all things, and that if truth is true one place, it's true boo everywhere. So we're going to look at relationship with self and God, how that's intertwined. And then how you need to have that type of that relationship first in a healthy way before being able to really have a relationship with that special someone. And then how all of that comes to play with a relationship with the world and the media, and how our culture can tend to really have a false representation of what are relationships, what are healthy relationships, and all of that jazz. So we looked at love. What is love? This idea, and how our Christian faith teaches that love is based on the Trinity, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, and how it's God is relationship itself, and it is the freely giving and receiving of love. How the Father can be the Father and stay the Father, the Son can be the Son and stay the Son, the Holy Spirit can be the Holy Spirit. There's this beautiful diversity, and that's what love is. This the ability to have this diversity and be who we are, but yet freely give and receive love, not force and take. And we're going to talk about that in a minute here. And the idea of love and grace and love and freedom we're going to talk about, and that question of, you know, how free are we? And we also talked about what is grace. And so grace is this life-giving spirit, this gift from God that says, like, no, you can't do everything on your own. You can't try to control everything with your free will. We need to be able to open ourselves to this love of grace. And I talked about Amazing Grace, and how what that song came from is the slave ship captain, that he ran a slave ship, and like people would go and take people and put them in the bottom of the ship, and people would die in there and were treated horribly, less than human. What happened was there's this big storm that came this one night, and in that storm, he had this realization, this grace was moved to this love to realize what he was doing was wrong, and that he was the same as the people that he had in the bottom of the ship. And so this amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. And it wasn't by his own doing. It was by his opening his heart to God's love and grace that he realized what he was doing was wrong, and then became an advocate to the abolition of slavery. And so that's this idea of grace. What does grace have to do with our relationship with ourselves and our relationship with others? And so we're going to look at the love of self. We're going to look at the idea of freedom. How do we let go into grace? How do we enter our darkness with forgiving love? And I talked about the idea of waiting, how our culture has a really hard time waiting. Everything is instant, 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 instant. But things like suffering, relationships, love, all of life's biggest questions and biggest things that we live in art, have to do with our ability to wait. And so we'll talk about that. And how do we embrace our light with life-giving love? So the recap here is our ability to accept lovingly our darkness and our light. So we're going to look at that. They talked about how how we see God, how we see the universe, how we see life, will also affect our relationship with ourselves and with the world and with each other. So if I think the world is a horrible, scary place, that's going to be really hard for me to be able to trust people, to be able to enter my life with love, with an open heart to give and receive. And so this important idea of how is it then that I see, if I can start to be able to align my heart with Christ, with love, how can that shape how I interact with myself and with each other and with the world? So this universal Christ, Christ everywhere, always and everything, and how Jesus, in the Bible it says Jesus, everything is drawn to God. And so this idea that with Christ, Jesus draws everything to him. Jesus, so everything that happens in your life, even if it's really difficult, in our faith, it's God is saying, you know, it's not God making the thing happen, but it's God and Christ saying, give it to me and we can use it for beauty. It can be used for goodness. It can be used for love. It doesn't make the thing easy. It doesn't make the thing not like a heaping pile of garbage, but what it does is it helps us to be able to move through it and see how it can be used for light and for love and for beauty. So this idea of how God and Christ can use all things for good. And so there's a video here on the Trinity that to watch. And then we talked about the idea of love. Does love have conditions? And it's interesting because Father Ron Rollheiser, talking about the Adam and Eve story, says, yes, love does have a condition. And here is the condition. When Eve isn't given the apple, she takes it. You can't take love and you can't force love. It has to be freely given and freely received. And that's huge. And that's a real art to learn how to do. And what I did then is I put a student on a chair and I had tape, and I did the tape and say, okay, this piece of tape here, this is when so-and-so was really young and had a picture that he drew and was very excited about. And instead of embracing it, the mom said, that's really not that good and I don't have time for you anyway. And then that hurt. I taped the kid to the chair and went through all of these different hurts, and each was a piece of tape. And then I said, okay, you're free to go. You're free, but of course you can't, they couldn't get up. They couldn't be free because of all of these things. So when we're talking about a relationship with ourselves, it's talking about how do we heal these pieces of tape. If you hate the pieces of tape, you're going to have a hard time healing it. If you're blaming the pieces of tape, you're gonna stay stuck in that chair. See, and so this unit with when we're talking about being able to heal ourselves, our relationship with ourselves, that's what we're talking about. What are different practices that we can enter to try to heal these hurts within our lives? Grace and peace. Boop, boop.